I was home, not more than a couple months, when it was the Saturday night before Easter, and I was riding in the car along with my mom, and we were just talking, and kind of out of nowhere, just out of my mouth came, "I want to go to church tomorrow." You know, it wasn't really something that I planned to say or didn't even know was in my head at the time. It just kind of came out. Came the next morning, and I was just really, really moved by the service. You know, the story of Jesus and the crucifixion and the resurrection, really identified with that. You know, I felt even if like it was really my own story, almost. It was kind of crazy. But, you know, I just really felt it. I really felt the presence of something. Pastor Chris actually went up in front and led everyone in the salvation prayer, as I understand it. Without even really controlling myself, I just bowed my head and repeated back everything that he said at the end of it, with the amen, with everyone around me, the whole church, everyone doing the same thing. I just felt this absolute energy and this spine tingle, to be honest. When I said amen with my head bowed, tears just sprung from my eyes that, you know, I wasn't crying, I wasn't sobbing, they just sprung from my eyes. It was just tears, and I can only see it as tears of joy. And I just felt just invigorated and truly filled up with just everything, everyone around me. It's just an amazing feeling that I had never had before. I mean, it really felt like I was being filled up with what I believe now is the Holy Spirit. But, you know, at the time, I, you know, had no idea what was going on. My whole life, I've really been, I mean, I would call myself agnostic, but it would be more on the side of God probably doesn't exist. It's really a culmination of a lifetime of striving to achieve in the worldly realm, which I thought was everything at the time. I had no idea of this spirituality and things of that nature. And so I had really worked my entire life to go be this, to go work in finance in San Francisco and be what I thought was a big shot. And I did that, and I got there. You know, God didn't help me out, and, you know, he doesn't really exist. And I don't know, I kind of, you know, proved it to myself, I suppose. After a while of being there, I just, you know, I just didn't know. I mean, I was lost. You know, I was really alone in a foreign city that wasn't home. You know, I had achieved everything that I wanted to achieve, but at the same time, I just feel like I had left so much behind, and I was just trying to find the answer, trying to find what would fill the hole in my soul. I mean, the answer is spirituality and God. That was what was missing in my soul, in my, just the hollow cavity that I didn't see before, really, or I covered, I guess you could say, with, you know, worldly things, I suppose. Life is different today, having found faith and spirituality, in the way that I value things differently. Life does seem like it has a purpose now. I don't feel lost anymore. I mean, on a day-to-day, you know, I do see purpose to things that I do. Now today, I just feel that, you know, really anything is possible. And, you know, and the closer you get to God, the more things are possible. You know, a place of peace that, you know, it's, if I do anything right now, if I just get a little bit closer to God, then I am a little, then I'm taking one step in the right direction. That's been an absolute change. I mean, as well as I feel full, the void that I spoke about earlier has really been filled for the most part. You know, I no longer am so lost, you know, and I never feel alone, which I did. Jesus being the light of the world really does resonate, especially with, if you think about it, as far as hope. And that was, and hope was something that, you know, was kind of elusive for me for a while there. I thought I had really gotten to, I thought I had made it, and it turns out I hadn't made it at all. Jesus is the light of the world.